friends. Ones we can depend on. Friends.
Fix my shirt.
How many of us have them? Friends.
Slawson.
Before we go any further, let's be friends. The word we use every day. Most of the time we use it in the wrong way. Now you can lift the word up again and again, but the dictionary doesn't know the meaning of friends. And if you ask me, you know I couldn't be much help, because a friend's somebody you judge for
yourself.
Some are okay and they treat you real cool, and some mistake your kindness for being a fool. We like to be with some because they're funny.
Love that part.
Others come around when they need some money. Some you grew up with around the way, and you still will
put it in. Yo. What's up? I am your host, Jose Luis. See, this is Disposable. This is another episode of Disposable. If you guys can't tell what this episode's about, it's called Friends. Hence the title, hence the music that's just playing. It's just about friends. Now, before all five of you get in your feelings about this episode, this isn't about, it's about y'all, but it's not personally about y'all. It's really about the people that I've encountered in life that I've given the title of friends, where fallouts have happened, where people didn't have the best intentions. It's just a bunch of things. Friends, I had this episode written like maybe a month ago. I wrote this right after the first Disposable episode, right? After the first one. So I've been trying to do this for a while. I just haven't had time to. So, let me go into this. Growing up, I had a shitload of friends. A shitload. Like over 30, 40. If you're like 30 or 40, that's a lot of friends. As an adult, you're like, yeah, that's a lot of friends. Not everybody's really there your friend. You don't learn that till you get older. And if you don't think I had that many people growing up as my friends, personal friends, people I actually knew, chilled with every goddamn day, bro, If I could call my mother right now, and I'd be like, yo, when I used to go to school, how many people used to come to the crib to come get me? She would tell you, maybe 15. Minimum, 4. But 4 to 15 people would come. Hey, is Jose here? Let's go. Great. Now, as I stated, as an adult, that shit all goes away. Like, having that many friends, there's acquaintances, don't get that twisted. There's a difference between friends and acquaintance. Friends are like my brothers. Niggas is my brothers, like my mother's kids. Jigga, in case you wanted to know. So, it's like, yeah, if I give you that title now, like, you know, I got you. Like, whatever, I got you. And it's just so many things. Now, I wrote things down on my phone because I haven't done this in a while. So, yeah. A friend. They just said it. The dictionary can't really define it. To me, my version of a friend is somebody that has good intentions for you. Someone that's not seeking anything for you. Someone that, if you have a fallout, a blowout, any of that shit, that you don't have to worry about them going to people about your business that you told them in confidence. Like, that's what a real friend should do. If you were lucky enough to get bestowed a title as friend or best friend, that's something that you have to stand tall on. It doesn't matter how bad the friendship went. That's something that somebody told you in confidence, and you don't want to violate that confidence, because then if you do, then you should really be questioning your integrity as a person, not just a friend, as a person. That goes more of a morals composition than anything else. But yeah. Now, friends also doesn't mean, as much as people would like to think it's for life, it's really not for life. I've had this conversation before with people, and they get mad when I have this conversation. But sometimes people are in your lives as in sections, right? They're only meant for this section in your life, and you either drift apart or you outgrow them. shit just happens. The best you could do from that situation is learn from it. Now, in my situations, I learned a hell of a lot from my situations. Like, there's a picture I'm about to throw up. That's the thumbnail. Those are people that I grew up with. Those are some of the people I grew up with. I don't have contact with them no more. And it's not on some, like, well, some of them are some beef shit. But the main important one, we just fell apart. We just, not fell apart, we fell out, we drifted apart. We went to two different worlds. When I say my brother, he was my brother for that section in time. My birthday is July 22nd, his birthday is July 24th. They didn't really celebrate my birthday like that here, so guess what? He always shared his birthday with me. So that's love. It's just after some time, people, you start chilling with other people. Other people don't vibe with you, they don't fuck with you, and they start putting ideas in people's heads. And I think that's what really happened. Now, I'm not going to sit here and lie to you and be like, oh, I was a fucking saint. No, I was the bestest of friends. No, it took time for me to get to that stage of life now. Like I said, when I say you learn from shit, I think I could give you maybe two or three examples of that. So, out of the 15 people that used to pick me up every day, blah, 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 fallouts happened. Everybody just kind of went their different ways. And then there was people that was always like, yo, let me hold some money, let me hold some money, let me hold some money, let me hold some money. And I was like, wait, does this motherfucker think I'm a bank? And then it's like, all right, let me just start easing away from that. And then there was people that put you in clear danger. Like, they put you in danger and they'll come back like, ain't shit happened. Like, an altercation would be started. And then when the altercation takes down, not there. You're there by yourself. So shit would be crazy like that. One of the worst situations I had was through a friend, right? Through a friend, we were supposed to link up, blah, 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 blah. So when I get to the destination to go meet the friend, there's a guy there. There's just a random guy there. I'm like, who the fuck is this guy? I'm like, all right, whatever. Like, it's a busy street, whatever. Next thing I know, I'm being robbed with a shotgun. A shotgun. I was gonna get my life taken away from me for $120. $120. And I grew up poor, so $120. I'm like, oh, yo, fuck it. I'm about to die for $120. And I'm like, yo, nope. Process shit. Let me get it together. But like, when I sit back and think about it, I'm like, yo. Like, I really sat back. I analyzed the situation. The only person I knew was going to be there. It was a coincidence. Everything just aligned. And I was like, oh, you set me up. You were somebody like I gave that title to. And it's like, okay. Then there's people that you went to school with, you think they're your peoples, and then you realize you're really outside of the group. You're not in the group, you're outside the group. And then they try to do some funny shit. But as you get older, you're like, all right, no. The people that I'm looking at now that I deem friends are people that actually go out their way to make sure you're okay, and make sure you're straight, make sure you're doing good, check up on you. You don't have to talk every day. But once you check up on them, it's like, all right, cool. No, we're straight. We got it. So it's like all of these things come into place. The second time that I fumbled the second friend encounter that I'm about to mention is I fumbled the friendship. I fucked it up. And that was me and this girl. And she was cool as shit. It's just that, how can I break this down? So we were both in like, all right, so we had there was mutual feelings here, but we were both in relationships and neither of us was really gonna step out like that on each other. So it was like, all right, cool, got it. But there would be times and moments day we were like messed up on our friendship. So there will be times where I'll be talking to a girl, blah, 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 blah. She'll be like, yo, who the fuck is that bitch? And I was like, hey, yo, what's going on? That's weird. And there'll be times at the moment where she was like, oh, you know, this, that, and my mans. And I was like, all right, cool. And looking back at it, the friendship really got tested on one night, right? The friendship really got tested on one night. And to be honest, it was her spazzing on me. It was, all right, so I only take so much disrespect. Like, I'm really calm, I'm level-headed, I sit back, I analyze the situation. It took people trying to kill me to get to that point. But it was like, all right, now it's like, all right, so she just kept catching an attitude. And what was the fight about? It wasn't dumb, but it was a reason for a fight. So I told her, like, yo, if you continue to talk to me like this, yo, like, I'm dead in that shit. There's no point. There's no purpose of this to transpire, because we're not fucking each other. We're not doing any of that shit. So it's like, what the fuck is we doing? Like, don't be talking to me left. Don't be coming at me crazy. Now, sitting back and analyzing that situation, is like, I probably could have, not just me handled it better, but she could have handled it better, and then the whole thing would have transpired to be a better thing. But me and her were both stubborn, like stubborn. So I was like, all right, fuck you. And she was like, all right, fuck you too then. And then we never talked. So, but she was like definitely like one of my like closest friends. I talked to her every fucking day. Every day about everything, about nothing, every day. And then, as you can probably see, like, yeah, sometimes I still miss her. Yeah, that was like one of the people. Everybody has that one friend that they really fucking miss that they don't talk to. It's just really ego. So she stood 10 toes down on her shit. I stood 10 toes down on my shit. We bumped into each other and we did exactly what we said. I'm very about keeping to your words. I'm 1000% about keeping to your words. If you're gonna say, I ain't gonna do that shit no more, that's what I expect you to do. Not do that shit no more, that's what I'm gonna hold you accountable to. So when me and her said, yo, we both, once we get to that point, we're like, all right, fuck them, I'm gonna walk past you like I don't fucking know you, that's exactly what we both did. And I think we were both taken back a little, like, yeah, wait, he didn't acknowledge me and shit. I'm like, this bitch didn't acknowledge me. All right, fuck it. All right, fuck him. Like, okay. And it was like, wait a minute. And it's like, I was like, wait, all right, so it's really done. And it was cool. Me and her both learned a lot from each other. So that shit was like so fucking funny. And yeah. And there's a third one. The third one is outgrowing, all right? It's hot as fuck. I had to turn off all my fans and AC to record this with this light in my face. So the third one is just drifting apart. Shit happens. A lot of people don't get shit happens. A lot of people have lives. A lot of time life happens. People move away. If they don't move away, they can still be in the same vicinity as you. Guess what? Life happens. You got to take care of your family. You got to take care of your mama, pops, whatever the situation is. You got to bring in the money to take care of everybody to maintain. And you don't have time to talk to everybody. It doesn't mean that you're not fucking with each other no more. You're probably not fucking with each other no more. But it doesn't mean it ended on a negative term. It's just shit goes their separate ways. And I know a lot of people get offended by that, but you're not supposed to get offended by that. You're supposed to take a lesson from everything that you get. So, yeah. So me growing up, it was like, all right, putting too much stress. Nope, don't do that. Letting my ego get in the way. Don't do that. And it was being too trusting. Yeah. Or not trusting enough. Because to be honest, like, when somebody attempts to take your life, you're not going to be trusting nobody for shit. So it's like all of these things come into play. It's fucking crazy if you ask me. Yeah, learning how to be trusting and not trusting people, yeah. The other one was people don't have the best intentions, the people with ulterior motives. See, when I started this recording shit, I was like, yeah, I want to work with everybody, I want to do things, blah, 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 go, 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 go. And it's like, all right, cool. And then it's like, people, random people that never had a conversation with me. Like, I extended my hands to, like, the people that actually fuck with me. So I was like, all right. And then there was people that didn't fuck with me, that came out of nowhere, and, like, they just wanted, like, if you come with me with pure love and, like, pure motives, all right, man, what do you need to learn? Because I said this to everybody that ever wanted to learn how to do this shit. I was like, yeah, I'll sit down and teach you and blah, 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 blah. Cool. But there has to be a genuine mutual relationship there. If you're just there like, oh, man, yeah, that's cool. Ha, 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 that's funny. And it's like, all right, I'll ask you a question. That's my best thing. I like throwing out feelers. I'm like, oh, so... did you hear about this shit? And he'd be like, yeah, man, you know, yeah, this shit is crazy. I'm like, what do you think about that? Like, oh, no, 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 no. And I'd be like, well, I talked about it on my show, and you're allegedly fucking with my show. They're like, oh, no, no, I just forgot it. I was like, all right, cool, whatever. But I noticed when I got this equipment, people would just show up out of nowhere, and I'd be like, oh, hey, do you... I don't know if this is too much. Let me know. Let me know, big bro. Is this too much? Can I hold your equipment? Can I borrow your stuff? Hold up. What if we leave it on this one place and then we all could use it? And I'm like, excuse me? And it's like, all right. And once you give them like a no answer, they magically like fall off the face of the earth. They magically like, you never hear from them again. That's why it's like the people that I fuck with, the people that you've seen on the show so far, like I genuinely fuck with them. And I was like, all right. And I'm like, you see this hat right here? You see this hat? This is because of my cousin. Like, the reason I'm bringing him up is because it has to do with people that that speak good about you, that represent you when you're not there. And that's definitely my cousin. Every time my cousin's always talking about the show. He loves the show. And I fucks with him for that. And I try to repeat the favor. I try to, like, what's the proper phrasing? I try to, like, I try to redo the same kind of gesture as well. So the way he promotes my show is the same way I try to promote his business. I actually have somebody on the line for you, Buzz. All right, so... someone that represents you, always somebody that talks good about you when you're not there. That's what you want in life. And that's what I try to do for him the same way he does for me. You see this hat that I have on? The reason I bring this up is because when I would go meet up with my cousin, he'd always have the PTO hats on. And I'm walking around with a bum-ass Mets hat. They're going to kill me for that shit too. But I be walking around with a Mets hat, Yankees hat, because they match my outfit. So I was like, nah, I can't be doing that because I have my friends, my family, wearing my merchandise, and what am I doing? I'm the only person now rocking my merch. And it's like, that's why it's like, it's very important who you give that title. And I hold future friends to that standard. Like, all right, somebody that's gonna talk good about me when I'm not there. That's exactly what you want. It's a very important thing. That's why I mentioned in the beginning of the show, I was like, yo, you want somebody that if you're friends with, guess what, you have a fallout, they're not going to go run around and tell somebody all your shit. Now, the other thing is, while we're on this topic of like, are you a good friend? Is like, yo, you really need to like sit back and reflect and look at the things that you did. I don't know if I'm repeating this because my camera died, but you really need to sit back and just observe the situation. Like... am I treating them the same way that I want to be treated? Am I holding them down the same way they're holding me down? Like, all mutual shit. It's like, all of that. Being a friend for somebody right when is not beneficial. Not beneficial is not the correct word. When it's not convenient. Anybody could be your friend when it's convenient, but when you're going through some shit, like, you really need somebody to talk to, you need to know who you could really get on the horn with or meet in person and rely on that person that'll give you the best knowledge possible for you to move forward with your actions and shit like that. A lot of people don't get that. And accountability. For me, I'm stubborn. I'm stubborn as fuck. When I'm in the right. Now, I'm very thoughtful. I'm considerate. I give motherfuckers the benefits like I'm a goddamn Medicare line. Motherfuckers will get all the benefits of me when it comes to the doubt. Like, always. Like, I'll sit back. I'll look at the situation. I'll try to view it from your point of view. But if I'm in the right, I'm dying on that hill, no matter what. Like, I know I'm stubborn like that. And this isn't the first time, like, I've ended a friendship off of that. Like, nope, I'm 100% right. You could call it ego, but if I'm 100% right and you're not looking at it from my perspective to see if you can't see from my perspective why I'm upset over a situation, then I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what's the point of this. There's no point of me going back and forth. You can't take the 2 seconds to sit back and reflect and be like, okay, now I get it. I've always been that person. Now as an adult. Like I can't. Life is too short. I can't tolerate certain shit. I'm sorry. I don't make a scene. I don't do that. I don't make a scene. I just fall back. I disappear. I'm like, you'll never hear from me again. A lot of people will say that's not the best option either, but guess what? It's better than having a blowout. It's better than people yelling. I don't have time for that. Like, especially if it's not gonna go nowhere. If it's not gonna go nowhere, it's not gonna get resolved, then what's the point? And I don't really feel, once I get to that point with somebody, it's like, all right, you don't appreciate me or acknowledge me for the person that I am, so there is no point to go on further with a conversation. That's just me. That's the way I've been. I don't know why I'm like that, but just why I'm like that. Yeah, this is something that, like, I've been wanting to put out. Because friends is very important, man. A lot of people don't get it. Friends is who you invite into your life. Friends are people that are gonna be there for important events if you let them in. And they really should be there. Like all these things that come into play. You also need to know when to take a break every now and then. A lot of people don't get that. I'll be honest, right now, I'm not talking to one of my best friends. I only have five friends. And I have five friends and they're all my best friends just because those are the people that I go to. All right, I'm not talking to one of them right now. It fucking sucks. But guess what? Whatever me and them are going through, we're gonna have to go through. We're gonna have to go through the motions, whatever. It's not no animosity shit, it's not no hate shit. I just feel that I need space and time. Like, space and time, that's all I'll ever be asking for a lot of the times. They know, well, they should know that I love them. Whenever they truly need me, I'll be there. Like, they could call me right now. While I'm recording this, I'll take this shit, throw it on the floor, and go attend to that person right away. But as of right now, I can't see myself at this moment being in conversation, talking, things going back to the way it used to. It's just the way it is. And right now I'm just taking this time, like, to really sit back and observe, really think about shit. And if it ever goes back to the way it used to be, or it doesn't, like I just mentioned before, like, people are sectional in your life. Like, C's was sectional. That was my friend, but that was more of Kevin's friend. And we took what we needed from each other, what we can combine, what we put together, and then we went our separate ways. And same thing with him. No animosity, no anger there. It's just life, just the way life goes. And they were both given, like, all right, whenever you need me, like, seriously. Because we did have that bond. The bond is there, it's just, we're not talking. And that's just the way life goes. But yeah, friends, like, it's very important who you choose to have in that group who you give that title to, because that person's also a representation of you. And it's like, if you just let anybody be your friend, then what does that really say about you? So this has been another episode of Disposable. Thank you. I really don't know how this really came out. I can't tell if I was just rambling. This is my first time turning on this camera in over 2 to 3 months, and I'm really mad about that, but it's gonna eventually, everything's getting worked out to go into place. So please give me a thumbs up. Please continue to like, share, comment, subscribe. I am your host, Jose Luis from Slauson. And thanks, guys. Peace.